Okay, just a few more tips before we proceed of masking different things. You can buy masking sheets from an art supply store that are all gridded out. You can cut out the shape if you want to mask out a very large area. However, you will have hard edges, and that's a thing you have to deal with, is hard edges. We don't want to have that unless it's really intended to be. What I have in front of me is a plain piece of waxed paper. Normally I would take a pen because pencil would probably break, but what I'm going to do here is I've decided, for example, that I want to have a fence line, and I'm pressing really hard with my waxed paper. Again, I wish I had something. Maybe I'll use a palette knife or something so it gives me more. I'll do some more lines here. Okay, so I take that away. I pre-planned this so that when I take that away, now I have an area that I want to have that show up. If I did it really, really. Uh-huh, there it comes. You see right there, you really have to look closely, but there is a fine line there. Now, I used normal wax paper, but what you can use is if you go to the local butcher shop and get some that's really, really waxy, it will help to make that resist a lot better. Another one is the razor blade. I'll take a razor blade and I'll drag it along the paper to make a fine line. And I paint over that. This will work even better because it's much sharper. You can see the line that I've made there. It's very subtle. But if you wanted to really mutilate the paper, drag the razor blade sideways a bit more. If you wanted to make it like a barbed wire fence or something, you can do that and paint over it. You'll see how that line, that's really starting to show up there now, see? So you can make a barbed wire fence or any kind of wire that you want just by dragging that razor blade sideways over the paper. When I paint fences, I cheat a little bit, I admit, and I use something called a pigma pen. Pigma pen is approved by the Library of Congress to last for almost forever. It's a permanent micron pen, comes in different widths. This is one that I would use for drawing, say, a fence. Once I've got the fence painted, I can paint a fence here quickly. So I've got the fence posts dark enough here so you can see them. So we've got a fence post like that. So I would paint, after that is dried, I'd paint in my wire. I'm skipping here. And you know, you make it so that it looks like barbed wire on these old fences. And you can use that little push-pull thing, little X's, just to suggest that perhaps the wire is barbed rather than just being straight. And that will last forever. I also sign my paintings with a pigma pen because it's much easier than using a fine brush. And it'll last forever, okay? So that's the use for a pigma pen that is probably going to save you a lot of grief, because if you start printing, especially a name as long as mine, using a small brush, it's not the greatest. I even sign my oil paintings with a pigma brush, so it's a lot thicker, and it's a black signature, and I just use that right over a completely dry oil painting, and it will last forever. It's been proven to do that.